Hello, welcome students for the chemistry class. In the last class, I explained you about colligative properties plus first colligative property, that is relative lowering of vapor pressure. Relative lowering of vapor pressure. Just we will recollect what is meant by colligative property. What is meant by colligative property? The property which depend on number of particles but not on the nature of the particles are called colligative properties. There are four colligative properties, that is relative lowering of vapor pressure. This is already in last class I explained. And another elevation in boiling point, elevation of the boiling point, and depression of its freezing point. And fourth one is osmotic pressure of the solution. So out of these four colligative properties, first one relative lowering of vapor pressure already completed. In this class, the remaining two, that means elevation in boiling point and depression in freezing point, I will explain in this class. Okay, we'll start elevation in boiling point. So this is second colligative property. Elevation in boiling point is a second one. Elevation of boiling point. So here boiling point is there. So boiling point depends on vapor pressure. So again you have to start from vapor pressure. So the vapor pressure of a solution, the vapor pressure of the solution at a given temperature is found to lower than the vapor pressure of the pure solvent at the same temperature. I already explained so many times P and P naught. P naught is vapor pressure of solvent. P is vapor pressure of solution. P is always less than P naught. Vapor pressure of solution, vapor pressure of solution is lower than that of vapor pressure of pure solvent. Vapor pressure of pure solvent. Next point is, in this solution, why it is lower? Because in this solution, the non-volatile solute particles obstruct the escaping of solvent molecules from the surface. Because solute particles occupies the surface, some places of solvent, so they will prevent escaping of solvent molecules into the vapor phase. So that's why vapor pressure of solution is less than vapor pressure of pure solvent. As you know that already we discussed, as the temperature increases, vapor pressure also increases. As temperature increases, vapor pressure increases. You can see here, it is at room temperature. Here, number of molecules present in vapor phase, only 4 are there, only 4. Here, room temperature, 4 only there. Here, pressure is less. Vapor pressure is less because here temperature is room temperature, less temperature. You can see in this diagram, you are heating, you are providing temperature. Temperature increased because you are using burner and started heating. Because temperature increased, number of molecules which travel from solid surface, liquid surface into vapor phase also increases. Here number of molecules increases. As a result, number of vapor molecules increases. As temperature increases, evaporation increases, number of molecules increases, hence vapor pressure also increases. Here you can see here vapor pressure increased because of increase in temperature. High vapor pressure, temperature is more, high vapor pressure. So as you know that as the temperature increases, the vapor pressure also increases. You can see in this slide, this is pure solvent. Total surface is occupied by solvent molecules only. It is solvent and solute, that means solution. In solution, surface is occupied by both solvent and solute molecules, because solution is a homogeneous mixer. As a result, number of solvent molecules here decreases. Here number of solvent molecules more, because it is a pure solvent, here vapor pressure is P naught. It is a solution, its vapor pressure is P. Vapor pressure is less because number of molecules of solvent in vapor phase is less because of some solute molecules occupies surface. This point also you have to remember for understanding the next topic. You see here, this is important. As temperature increases from this side, as temperature increases, vapor pressure of pure solvent, first of all we will see it is vapor pressure of pure solvent increases. It is at room temperature, vapor pressure of pure solvent is this one. As temperature increases, vapor pressure increased up to this one. Temperature further increase, vapor pressure increase. Further increased temperature, vapor pressure increased. So, at a particular temperature, this vapor pressure of pure solvent is equal to atmospheric pressure. This is atmospheric pressure. Atmospheric pressure, that means one atmosphere. That means vapor pressure of pure solvent, as temperature increases, vapor pressure of pure solvent increases and it reaches to 1 atmosphere at a temperature. What is this temperature? This temperature is boiling point, TB, boiling point of pure solvent, TB naught. It is boiling point of pure solvent, TB naught. Okay. TB naught is the boiling point of pure solvent. Next you will see, it is the curve, this curve, CD curve. C is the starting point. It is the vapor pressure of solution at room temperature. You know vapor pressure of solution is less than the vapor pressure of pure solvent. C value is less than A. This is the vapor pressure of solution. This is vapor pressure of pure solvent. C value is less. Even though it is less value, as temperature increases, this vapor pressure of solution also increases. Vapor pressure of solution also increases. It is increased. As temperature increases, vapor pressure increases. Because its vapor pressure is less than pure solvent, so to reach atmospheric pressure, it needs more temperature, because its vapor pressure of solution is less. To reach this atmospheric pressure, it requires more temperature. So at higher temperature, this solution vapor pressure also equal to atmospheric pressure. Solution vapor pressure is equal to atmospheric pressure at this temperature. This temperature is called boiling point of solution. It is denoted by TB. Why this TB value is more than TB naught? TB naught is boiling point of pure solvent. TB is boiling point of solution. You know TB value is here start from 0 to this side, TB value this one, TB naught value this one, TB value is next one. So TB value is greater than TB naught. Boiling point of solution is greater than boiling point of pure solvent because of lower. This is boiling point of pure solvent TB0. This is boiling point of solution TB. So boiling point of solution is greater than boiling point of pure solvent because solution vapor pressure is less. So this based on this only this elevation of boiling point will come. So what is boiling point? Already you discussed. Now the temperature at which vapor pressure of the solvent, it may be solvent or solution, this vapor pressure of the solvent is equal to the atmospheric pressure. The temperature at which the vapor pressure of the solvent is equal to atmospheric pressure is called boiling point. Boiling point is a bulk phenomena, you know, surface phenomena, evaporation is surface phenomena, boiling point is a bulk phenomena. At boiling point, vapor pressure of solvent is equal to atmospheric pressure, that is one atmosphere. So let TB naught, this naught always stands pure. TB naught be the boiling point of pure solvent, and TB is the boiling point of solution. TB naught boiling point of pure solvent, TB boiling point of solution. Just in previous slide I explained between TB naught and TB which one has more value, boiling point of pure solvent, boiling point of solution. You take pure water, its boiling point is 373.15 Kelvin. You add some salt, its boiling point increases because of its non-volatile solute. TB value is more. So increased, boiling point of solution is increased. The increase in the boiling point is known as elevation of boiling point. It is denoted by delta TB. What is delta TB? TB minus TB naught. What is TB? TB boiling point of solution. What is TB naught? Boiling point of pure solvent. The difference between boiling point of solution and boiling point of pure solvent is known as elevation of boiling point. The increase in the boiling point of solution is known as elevation of boiling point. Delta TB is directly proportional to molality of the solution. Delta TB is directly proportional to molality of the boiling point is directly proportional to molality of the solution. Because you add more amount of solute is added means there is a decrease in vapor pressure is more. So decrease in vapor pressure is more means you have to heat more. So that means its boiling point is increased. So that means delta TB naught, elevation in boiling point is directly proportional to molality. So that's why delta TB elevation in boiling point is directly proportional to molal concentration, molality, small m. That implies you can write delta TB is equal to some constant KB into molality. So what is delta TB? Boiling point of solution minus boiling point of pure solvent is equal to KB into molality. KB is a constant called as ebullioscopic constant. What is TB naught? Boiling point of pure solvent in Kelvin scale. What is TB? TB boiling point of solution in absolute temperature, that means in Kelvin scale. What is M? molality of the solution. What is meant by molality? What is meant by molality? Small m. What is meant by molality? The number of moles of solute present in one kg of solvent. The number of moles of solute present in molality is equal to number of moles of solute by mass of solvent in kg. So what is kb? Kb is a boiling point elevation constant. It is one name. Another name is molal elevation constant. Another name is ebullioscopic constant. Kb delta tb is equal to kb into m. In the next part, kf will come. That is also one constant called cryoscopic constant. Kb is called ebullioscopic constant. Because it is a elevation in boiling point, so it, you can call it as molal elevation constant. So kb, you will see kb, about kb, molal elevation constant. If how to define kb, already you know delta tb means elevation in boiling point is directly proportional to molality. That means delta tb is equal to kb into molality. In this equation, if you write m is equal to 1, small m is equal to 1, then delta tb is equal to kb. Small m is equal to 1 means, what is the meaning small m is equal to 1? You take 1 mole of solute, 1 kg of solvent. You take 1 mole of solute, dissolve in 1 kg of solvent, then m is equal to 1, because m is equal to number of moles by number of kgs of solvent, 1 by 1. So m is equal to 1. In that case, that change in boiling point, you can call it as boiling point elevation constant or ebullioscopic constant. Kb value depends on nature of solvent. For water, it has 1 kb value. For benzene, its kb value is different. What are the units of kb? Kelvin, kg per mole. You see, in this formula, delta tb is equal to kb into m. How to get kb? Kb is equal to delta tb by m. Delta T means change temperature units, Kelvin. Molality units, moles per kg. So in reverse, it is a kg mole inverse. Kelvin, kg, mole inverse. These are the units of Kb. So for solving numericals related to this elevation in boiling point, some concept, one formula you have to derive. So I will explain that formula now. You take in this diagram, W1 gram of solvent. Already, always we are using per solvent. For solvent, how much mass you are taking? W1 gram of solvent is taken. In this, W2 gram of solute is dissolved. You know, W1 is mass of solvent, W2 is mass of solute. It is unknown solute, its molecular mass, molecular weight you don't know, that is M2. Unknown solute, molar mass M2. By adding this one, its vapor pressure decreased. After heating, its vapor pressure increased and reaches boiling point. So this, it is the high vapor pressure. By heating, you got this one. So this vapor pressure is equal to atmospheric pressure, 1 atmosphere. Vapor pressure of liquid is equal to 1 atmosphere at a particular temperature. That temperature is called boiling point. So You know molality formula, molality is equal to number of moles of solute, that means W2 by M2. W1 is mass of solvent in kg. So molality is equal to W2 by M2, that means number of moles, into 1000 by W1, that means mass of solvent in grams. You are using 1000 means mass of solvent in W1 grams. So W1 is mass of solvent in grams, W2 is mass of solute in grams, M2 is molar mass of solute. If you know all these values, you can calculate molality. That is, you know M value, it is KB. So delta TB is related to KB into M. So delta TB is equal to KB into M. Instead of M, you write that molality formula. What is the molality formula? W2 by W1 into 1000 by M2. So from this formula, you can separate M2 to one side, M2, because by using colligative property, you have to calculate molar mass of unknown solute. It is the main use of colligative properties to calculate molar mass of unknown solute. So this formula we are frequently using for solving numericals. M2 is molar mass of unknown solute. KB is ebullioscopic constant. It will vary from one solvent to another solvent. W2 is mass of solute in grams, 1000. Delta TB, change in boiling point, elevation in boiling point. W1 is mass of solvent in grams. So this formula you have to use for solving numericals. So you will see first numerical. So 18 grams of glucose, 18 grams of glucose, glucose formula C6H12O6. 18 grams of glucose is dissolved in 1 kg of water, 1 kg of water. At what temperature will the water boil? At 1.013 bar, KB per water is given, KB per water. So what is given? 18 grams of glucose, one mass given, 1 kg of water, another mass given. So which one is W1, which one is more solvent? That is, this one is W1 is more, 1 kg of water. It is less, this is W2, mass of solute is 18 grams, mass of solvent is, sorry, weight of solute is 18 grams, weight of solvent is 1 kg, that means 1000 grams given, 1000 grams given. M2, molar mass of solute, molar mass of solute, that means glucose, C6H12O6, so that is 180. 180 is the molar mass of solute. You know KB value also given in the question itself. KB is 0.52 Kelvin kg per mole. So this is the given data in the question. You know the formula for elevation in boiling point. Delta TB is equal to KB into molality. This quantity is molality. Delta TB is equal to KB into molality. So delta TB is equal to, instead of KB, you can write 0.52. Mass of solute is 18. Molar mass of solute is 180. 1000 by mass of solvent is also 1000. 1000 cancelled. 18 cancelled. So 0. So 0.52 by 10. So 0.052 Kelvin. This 0.052 Kelvin is increase in boiling point, that means elevation in boiling point. So del TB naught, this one you know, boiling point of water, that is in degree centigrade, 100 degree centigrade, you know boiling point of water, because at STP, this one at 1.013 bar, so boiling point of water is in Kelvins, 373.15 Kelvin. This is boiling point of pure solvent. Now, boiling point of solution is more than this boiling point of pure solvent. So TB naught plus increase. How much increase is there? Already calculated 0.052 Kelvin. So therefore TB is equal to boiling point of water plus elevation in boiling point, that is 0.052. Therefore TB is equal to 373.202 Kelvin. So this type of numericals will come you have to practice. It is about elevation in boiling point. We will move to next colligative property, that is the third one, depression of freezing point. Elevation increased, boiling point increased, elevation in boiling point. Freezing point, depression, decrease, decrease in freezing point, depression of freezing point. It is a third colligative property. So freezing point, you will see first of all, what is freezing point of a substance? It is a liquid. If you lower the temperature, then liquid, this liquid will become solid. So there exists an equilibrium between, liquid and solid. At this equilibrium only, the solid, liquid is converted into solid. Conversion of liquid into solid, this is called freezing, freezing point of a substance. So you can see here pure solvent, for example water. What is the water freezing point? You see 0 degree centigrade. Freezing point of pure solvent is 0 degree centigrade. For this solvent, you add some solute. Then this will become solution. You check the freezing point of solution. If it is 0, this is a solvent. But here you can see freezing point, it came down. It is less than 0 degrees. That means minus 2 degrees centigrade came. Here 0 degrees, here minus 2 degrees centigrade. So that means lowering of freezing point. This one you can also called depression of freezing point. By adding some non-volatile solute, its freezing point becomes less. This is called depression of freezing point. The lowering of vapor pressure of the solution causes lowering of the freezing point compared to that of pure solvent. Vapor pressure of solution is less than pure solvent, already you know. Because of less vapor pressure only, its freezing point also of solution also less. A solution will freeze when its vapor pressure equals to vapor pressure of the pure solid solvent. So you will see, according to Raoult's law, when a non-volatile solid is added to the solvent, its vapor pressure decreases. Already we explained so many times. By adding non-volatile solute, its vapor pressure decreases, and now it would become equal to that of solid solvent at lower temperature. Thus, the freezing point of solvent decreases. In case of boiling point, increases. In case of freezing point, temperature decreases. So you can see here, in case of boiling point, like this, it is moving. You have to temperature increase. This is vapor pressure of pure solvent. It is vapor pressure of solution. So to reach this one, to this point, it needs more temperature. So that's why boiling point is more. But in this case, this solution, already it is a down, so it freezing, it will come this one. So it freezes at a lower temperature than this one. When compared to this one, its temperature is low. So freezing point of solution is less than freezing point of pure solvent. The vapor pressure of solution containing non-volatile solute is lower than that of pure solvent, and therefore it would become equal to that of solid solvent at a lower temperature. Maybe you got doubt what is solid solvent. Already I told there exists an equilibrium between liquid and solid. Solvent will become liquid. This liquid will become solid at a freezing point. This is equilibrium. Next, this delta TF. What is delta TF? Depression in freezing point is also delta TF. Delta TB is elevation in boiling point. Delta TF is directly proportional to molality. So, depression in freezing point is directly proportional to molality. That implies delta TF is equal to KF into M. So, what is delta TF? So, freezing point of pure solvent minus freezing point of solution is equal to KF into M. What is TF naught? Freezing point of solvent, pure solvent. What is TF? Freezing point of solution in Kelvin scale, in absolute temperature or in Kelvin scale. This difference is called depression in freezing point. It is directly proportional to molality. It is replaced, proportionality replaced with some constant KF. That KF is called cryoscopic constant. M is molality, already I explained. A KF is freezing point depression constant. Freezing, this F stands for freezing. Freezing point depression constant or molal depression constant, or one more name is cryoscopic constant. You will see about this cryoscopic constant. KF has three names: freezing point depression constant, molal depression constant, or cryoscopic constant. You know this formula, delta TF is directly proportional to molality. That means depression in freezing point is directly proportional to molality. Delta TF is equal to KF into M. If you write M is equal to 1, that means molality is equal to 1. That means 1 mole of solute equal to 1. That means number of moles of solute, 1 mole of solute is dissolved in 1 kg of solvent, then molality is 1. In that case, delta TF is equal to KF. So, molal depression constant, how to define? It can be defined as the depression in freezing point when 1 mole of solute is dissolved in 1 kg of solvent. 1 mole of solute is dissolved in 1 kg of solvent means molality is 1. If molality is 1, then the delta TF is equal to KF, molal depression constant or cryoscopic constant. You have to remember cryoscopic means low temperatures, freezing. Units of KF, what are the units of KF? Same units, KF and KB. KF, Kelvin, Kg, mole inverse. KF also depends on nature of the solvent. Both KF and KB units are same. Both KF and KB depends on nature of the solvent, but KF and KB values are not same. One is molal depression constant, another one is molal elevation constant. So, molal depression constant definition already discussed. So, for calculating this molal depression constant, one more formula also there. It is useful for our competitive exams like JEE and NEET. So, what is the formula? KF is equal to R into M1 into TF square by 1000 into delta H fusion. What is R? Gas constant. R is gas constant. What is M1? Same. M1 is molar mass of solvent. I told KF value depends on solvent. If it is water, 18. If it is benzene, you have to write 78. So, KF value varies from solvent to solvent because it depends on molar mass. What is TF? TF is freezing point of solvent. Freezing point of solvent. If you write TB here, TB, then it will become KB. So, what is delta H fuse? The enthalpy of fusion of this solvent. in case of KB, this TF becomes TB and it is delta H vaporization, enthalpy of vaporization. So boiling point elevation and freezing point depression. So molality K, well, K is molal freezing point constant. So values, KF values for some solvents, here KB values for some solvents. For you take benzene, KF is 5.12, unit is same, Kelvin kg per mole. For benzene, KB value is 2.53. So for same solvent benzene, KF value is one value, KB is one value. So you can see different CCl4, ethyl alcohol, water, these KF values. The KF has different values for different solvents. So, but units are same for KB and KF. So, some numericals you will see related to depression in freezing point. Before solving numericals, you will derive formula. If W2 grams of solute, here solute taken, what is the weight? W2 grams. What is the molar mass of solute? M2. This is important. You have to calculate molar mass of unknown solute. You don't know what solute is here. So its molar mass is M2. Its weight is W2. You are taking into some solvent. This mass, you know, W1 grams. W2, weight of solute is W2 grams. Weight of solvent is W1 grams. Molar mass is M2. Then molality formula, you know, molality is equal to number of moles of solute by mass of solvent in kg. That means if it is grams, it is also in grams, here 1000 will come. So you know delta TF is directly proportional to M. Delta TF is equal to KF into M. Delta TF is equal to KF into, instead of molality, you can write molality formula. You rearrange this equation, to shift this M to one side, so this one. So you take any numerical related to depression in freezing point, from these three formulas only you have to solve, and the last formula is important formula. So molar mass of non-ionic solute can be calculated by depression in freezing point. If you know delta TF value, you can calculate molar mass of unknown solute. So you will take one numerical. Calculate the mass of ascorbic acid. This ascorbic acid is present in vitamin C. Its formula also given. If you know the formula, you can calculate molar mass. You have to calculate mass. Dissolved in 75 grams of acetic acid. This is 75 grams is solvent, mass of solvent. That means W1. This is W1. Mass of ascorbic acid you have to calculate, W2 you have to calculate. Lower its melting point by 1.5 Kelvin, that means delta TF given, depression in freezing point given, KF value also given. You know the value of KF, you know delta TF, weight, one weight W1 you know, molar mass M2 given. W2 you have to calculate. Data you see, W1 is 75, delta TF given, KF value given, M2 is 176, molar mass of this ascorbic acid. W2, mass of that ascorbic acid you have to calculate by using this formula. It is the formula related to delta TF. So from this you substitute all the known quantities, M2 you know, KF you know, 1000, TF, delta TF, W1. You don't need the value of W2. So you solve this total numerical, you will get W2. Because it is a mass, so units are grams. What is the weight? 5.077 grams. That means 5.077 grams of ascorbic acid dissolved in 75 grams of acetic acid. Its lowest 1.5 Kelvin. You know vitamin C, nowadays it is very useful for this COVID. So you have to take vitamin C. So this one. Next up are applications. There are some applications related to this depression in freezing point. You can see this one, if temperature reaches 0 degree centigrade, this water in car radiator, water is in liquid state, this liquid will become solid, it will become ice. In winter season, in some places like Jammu and Kashmir and some other places, very cold areas, so the water in radiator becomes solid, ice. So it is difficult to run these vehicles. How to prevent this one? So by adding ethylene glycol, it is anti-freeze. By adding this one, this freezing point will decrease. Actually, water will freeze at 0 degrees centigrade. By adding ethylene glycol, its freezing point will become minus 10 degrees or minus 11 degrees or minus 12 degrees, like this. So freezing point is decreased. So at my up to minus 10 degrees, it is in liquid state only. So to prevent the conversion of water into ice, we are using anti-freeze ethylene glycol. It is for competitive exams also important bit. This is which one is used as anti-freeze ethylene glycol. What is the formula of ethylene glycol? These two carbons, each carbon is bonded with OH, diol. It is diol, ethane 1,2-diol. So this is ethylene glycol. Next application, a non-scientist may remain forever unaware of the boiling point. He don't know, he is a non-scientist, a common man. He don't know the boiling point, depression and other things. But he know how to melt this ice present on road by adding sodium chloride or calcium chloride. You can see here, some places the road is filled with ice. So to clear, this is a road. Actually, this is the road. This road totally covered with ice. How to clear this ice? So there is no sunlight also. In that case, you have to use this substance, salt, sodium chloride. One more salt is calcium chloride. Salt is added to melt ice by reduced freezing point. Because it freezes, water is present water at 0 degrees centigrade in the form of ice, solid form. By adding this non-volatile solute, its freezing point will become decreased, depression in freezing point. So the addition of these solutes depresses the freezing point of water to such an extent that it cannot freeze at the prevailing temperature. Then this road cleared. So that means total ice is converted into water by adding this non-volatile solute. So it is the application of freezing point of depression in freezing point. So by this I completed three colligative properties. Next one is osmotic pressure. In next class I will explain. Okay, thank you. Don't forget to like and subscribe to my channel. Okay, thank you.